Vande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Vinda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhu Vande Nityananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandana Vande Radhika Charanodayam Gopiyano Samayuktam Vrindavanam Manoharam Vāñcha kalpataru vasya kipāsindu vivacha Patitānang pāvunibha vaiṣṇavibhyo namo namah Mukhaṁ karoti vācālaṁ paṅgum laṅghaiti giriṁ Jat kipātamaṁ bandhi paramānanda mādhavam Vrindāvai tulsi devvai piyāvai kesavasvacha Krishna Bhakti Pada Devi Sattvatvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Narunche Ivanarottama Deving Swarasvating Vyasam Tato Yoyo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadesh Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadhanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagodvarunya Deyam Sada Parivavagna Mavishtadoham Tethas Padam Siva Virenchenutam Saranyam Beta Tiham Panodobal Bhavadibutam Bande Mahapurushate Charuna Ravindam Yat Pada Pallavanaka Chandamani Chataya Bispurji Takima Pigavadushu Adarsh Purna Nuragara Sasagara Sarumuti Saradhika Maikadam Kipam Karosh Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadihi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajahnulambita bhujo kanuka bodhatu Sankirtanai kavitaru kamala yataksho Visham varo diyavaro jugadharma palo Bande jagat priyakaru karuna bhataro Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare. Namami Gange Tava Pada Pankajam, Sura Surair Bandito Dibha Rupam, Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavan rupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramani ajata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushita vam bhagam Narayano priyamananga madapaharam Varanasi Purapati Bhajavi Shanatham Bhagi Sajasya Badane Lakshmi Rajasya Chavakshashi Jasyasthi Hidai Sambihir Tvam Nishingamaham Bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. न जन्म नो न महतो न सौवगम न बांग न बुद्धिर्नाकृति हेतु तैर्यदिष्टि न बनोकस चकार सक्षेबतलाक्षणाग्रज न जन्म नून महतो न सौवगम न बांग न बुद्धिर्नाकृति हेतु तैर्यदिष्टि न बनोकस चकार सक्षेबतलाक्षणाज चकार सक्षेबतलाक्षणाज आपदम अपहर्तारम दातारम सर्वसंपदम रामाभिरामम भूयो भूयो नमाम्यहम। गौरी गोष्ठीपति सिसिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दैट व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ विश्व वैष्णव राज सभा धामपचारिणी सभा व्हाट इज द एक्चुअल पर्पस ऑफ धामपचारिणी सभा and who can be a member of this sabha, that is the main question. Prabhupada going to give answer in the name of dambas kapat. In the name of dambas, if we plan to satisfy all our sense organ, in the name of dambas, in the name of staying in dhamma, if we are ready to enjoy our sense organ, then it is not dham seva. To satisfy material sense organ, to enjoy kama, those who are going to show falsely that they are staying in dhamma, that kind of shop we don't like to open. That is not actually the purpose of Dhampacharini Sabha. The real purpose of Dhampacharini Sabha is to give inspiration to those spiritual souls, those who are getting some inspiration to look into heart. Those who are trying to look inside heart, they are going to live, they are going to stop looking outside. They are going to stop looking outside for material enjoyment. Those who are going to look inside heart, to give them inspiration to understand what is Dham, what is Gaur Hari, what is Sankirtan Jagya. That is the purpose of Dham. It is the success of human life to devote whole life for Harinam Sankirtan Jagya. It is the success of human life to dedicate whole life for Bani Seva, Sankirtan Jagya, all the time. Srila Prabhupada speaking, if somebody going to misuse this purpose of Dhampacharya Sabha, those who want to represent themselves as a leader of Sabha, they can get huge punishment. Heavy punishment. Actually, if there is no resolution inside our heart, to quit, to leave asasanga, then there is no guarantee that we can get bhakti. If there is no resolution inside our heart to leave asasanga, in that case, there is no surety that we can get bhakti. Bhakti is not such a cheap thing. Prabhupada suggesting, all the time we'll have to protect the flame. All the time we'll have to protect the flame of Sankirtan Jagyagni inside our heart. Sankirtan Jagyagni we'll have to protect. We'll have to protect and preserve the Sankirtan Jagyagni inside our heart. If we fail to do that, in that case all different kind of mismanagement, infighting, the desire to find fault with pure devotees, jealousy, kapat bab, and vidyesh, hatred, can create some garbage inside our heart, which can make more problem. It can make a forest inside our heart of garbage. And as a result, Bhava Mahadavagni, I mean the fire of material, you know, world, can go on increasing inside our heart. We cannot get any peace in our life. That is the... So, we should always try to give full protection to the Sankirtan Jagyagni inside our heart, which we have received from our Guru Bhargava, Sauta Pantha. We must try to protect our Sankirtan Jagyagni, otherwise all our effort of bhajan can come to an end. Failure, totally failure. We should not go against Sauta Pantha. Prabhupada speaking, Sauta Pantha is all in all. Sauta Pantha can give us success in our life, bhajan life, but we are unlucky that those sadhus, those who are already established in Sauta Pantha, we like to go against them, we like to fight on them, we like to stop their Harikatha, we like to mislead people that they don't go and hear Harikatha. This way all different kind of poisonous situation creating is very unlucky we are. That's why long ago before leaving body, Prabhupada one day told to Paramananda Prabhu, Prabhupada, what you are looking outside, long time I have given prasadam to you, you are not taking prasadam. What you are thinking? Prabhupada speaking, I am watching outside, you know, in the garden, but actually I am watching that all your luck, good luck has got, you know, all burnt off. What you are looking outside in the garden, Prabhupada speaking, I am looking, your luck is so bad that you are going to burn up all your good lucks, you are going to burn. All different, if there is no Hari Bhajan, if we lose our connection with Guru Vaishnava, if we, the moment we lose our connection with Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan Nityananda, the moment we going to lose our connection with our previous Sauta Panthi Guru Varga, then be sure we can get deviated from the track of bhajan. No matter what besa, what kind of designation externally I have, it's matter little. Because in Kalikal I already told, those who are Shudra, they are going to take besa. Shudra men shokam karoti to Shudra. Those who are always lamenting, I am not getting pratishtha. I am not getting enough money and position. Oh my God, this kind of people, whatever base they are, sannyas, brahmachari, acharya, whatever. Prabhupada speaking, they are actually in Bhagavatam, it is written, Shudra pratigvesh shanti tapavesh upajivinaha. Their external base, external apron is one kind of business. They can try to collect money, everything, to secure their life, but this way they can never secure their life. Without Hari Bhajan, nobody can secure their life. Not possible. And dharman bhakshanti adharmagya adhiruro uttam asanam. Those who are adharmagya, those who are not, you know, pious, those who are not going to follow dharma, just opposite, they are going to climb vyasasan and going to pass lecture to other people to destroy the whole world. Upadesham karuti eva, jo upadesham karuti eva, no pariksham karuti jo. Those who are going to pass lecture only, not going to test, not going to practice practically, those who are going to show, only show, passing lecture, they are going to sit in Vyasasana and Kalikal, they can pass big, big lecture, Rabbananga Bhajan, Rupananga Bhajan, everything. They have no feelings, nothing. And about what is dharma, what is adharma, what is good, what is bad, what is, you know, what is nay, what is annai, what is not incorrect, what is correct. Only power, money power, manpower is all in all, in Kalika. Dharma about what is good, what is bad, what is dharma, what is not dharma, what is good, what is bad. About this judgment, only money power and manpower is all. They can pass judgment. They can pass remark about pure Guru Vaishnava. This is Kalika. And only scarred, they can show scarred. You don't know? I am Brahmin. You see my scarred. And about marriage, only like and dislike. I like you, you like me, let us go and marry. Dharma nyaya vavasthayam karanam balame vahi dampatyer abhiruchi. I like you, you like me. That's okay. If there is any disturbance, kick. They can kick each other and divorce. Dampatya avirucir vipratya sutram evahi. This is the condition. I am bound to say, before starting my actual Ramkatha, Ramtatha, first of all, I like to say, if there is no Ramlila, suppose only Krishnalila is there. Try to understand what I mean to say. If suppose there is no Ramlila in our list, only Krishnalila, then there is big problem. Why? Ramlila is such important lila that without Ramlila we cannot go. Ramlila can teach all common people. All those common people, they can have the privilege to go through Ramlila. They can hear, they can understand all different kind of complicated Siddhanta Vichar. They can hear about the pathetic life of Ramchandra, his ethical character, his morality, his honesty, his punctuality, his Guru Bhakti. That's all. Common people cannot understand more than that. Prabhupada speaking, even today those South Indian people, Prabhupada speaking, even today those South Indian people, they are busy with Ram Sita Seva, or maximum they are busy with Ram Chita Seva, or they are busy with Lakshmi Narayan Seva. They don't understand the activities of Krishna Chandra. What an excellent lila of Krishna Chandra they can understand. They cannot calculate. They try to calculate the way they fail. The estimation cannot reach up to certain point, which can give them, create some faith inside their heart. They say, okay, at least Ramchandra is very ethical character. Ram Sita is very good. Krishna is, no, it's not authentic, it's not good. And actually, Lakshmi Narayan is also good. There are some ethical characters there, some morality is there. What is Krishna doing? We don't know. Prabhupada with grief speaking, even today, South Indian people, they have no idea about what excellent Krishna Lila is. By chance it was Mahaprabhu Sri Krishna Chaitanya going to South India, and Venkat Bhatta, and they by chance, they get the chance to get the association of Paratpara Kilesha Gauranga Mahaprabhu in the form of Radha Baba, that on that time also not fully expressed, but still they got the privilege, so they could change their mood, actually change mood. Jive Sarup, all individual Sarup of all Jiva fixa. Surely their eternal Sarup was not as Lakshmi Narayan Bhakta. Surely. Otherwise, if he is sure, then by the association of Mahaprabhu it was also not possible. Like Ram, by Murari Gupta, he couldn't change. Even the association of Mahaprabhu Sri Krishna Chaitanya could not change the eternal Sarup, because it is fixed, eternal Sarup. So, At present, they were busy with Krishna, their Lakshminarayan puja, so their eternal sorrow was surely regarding Krishna bhajan, rasa tattva. So by the association of Mahaprabhu, they could change their mood, and they, like Prabhupada Saraswati Path, Gopal Bhatta Goswami, Venkat Bhatta, Trimala Bhatta, they got the chance to change. Anyway, there is a great influence in South India. South Indian people, they are feeling influence, great influence of Sitaram Bhajan or Lakshminarayan Bhajan, or most of them Mayavadi still today. I mean, Shankar Sampradaya have great, influence there all over. So long as people cannot have the chance to understand Gauranga Mahaprabhu, till then it is impossible for them to understand. Anyway, so where one very knowledgeable person, Gyani, Tattagyani Purush, in a society, in a sabha, where one Tattagyani Purush not getting any honor, the place where one Tattagyani Purush not going to get any honor, the place where one sadhu not going to get honor, the place where woman being, they are not going to get honor, the place where dharma, adharma, no demarcation is not there, what is dharma, what is adharma, surely you will have to leave that place. If you are not going to leave that place, soon, very shortly, you can lose all your bhajan and you can go down and down. Big problem. One sloka I was also speaking in Hindi Harikatha also, but I can discuss it in details when I can get scope to discuss all Upadeshamrita. Because it is the general instruction given that what is favorable you will have to accept, what is not favorable you will have to discard. This is the minimum thing. If you fail, then in infinity period you cannot do bhajan. What is favorable of bhakti you will have to accept. Bhakti anukula matru karjero sikar, bhakti pratikul bhava varjong angikar, sarang saranagati haive jahar, bhakti anukul karjo kacharo karjero sikar, bhakti pratikul kaj varjong angikar, bhakti anukul matru karjero sikar. What is favorable you can accept, what is not favorable you could discard. There should not be any weakness in it. No yatra vaikuntha katha sudha paga, no sadhavo bhagavataha stadasraya, no yatra yagye samakha mahasabaha, suresha loko pi no vaisa sevatam. It is from fifth canto, 19th chapter. No yatra vaikuntha katha sudha paga. If you are going to get so many facility for your bhajan, but there is no facility to hear Harikatha, Vaikuntha Katha, all different kind of AC, DC, prasadam, all different kind of, material amenity facilities you are getting, but if there is no facility for you to hear Harikatha from the lotus mouth of a pure devotee, you cannot stay there, because all other facility can take you to hell. Najatra vaikuntha katha sudhapaga. You will have to be sure that this is Harikatha, this is Vaikuntha katha, this is not material katha. In the name of Harikatha, I cannot hear material katha. You must be sure about it. You will have to ask your heart, you'll have to put question inside your heart. Is this Harikatha or not? If you are feeling pain, if you are going to change your mood, you are going to feel some reaction, be sure it is Harikatha. It's not material katha. Material katha can make compromise with Mayadevi. Prabhupada speaking, all people can go against me, all people can go against me, so I should not speak about their absolute truth. This is not bhakti. Baba speaking, if I speak about their absolute truth, all people can go against me, so I should not speak that way. We should speak a sweet way, so that is all common people can catch it in the name of Harikatha. Baba speaking, it is not actually Harikatha. Najatra Vaikuntha Katha Sudhapaga Na Sadhava Bhagavata Has Tadasraya. The place where you cannot find a pure devotee, those who are going to take the shelter of Supreme Lord 100%, because all the 26 qualities of Vaishnav, within this, all among this all 26 qualities, Krishnaika Saran, 100% inclination, 100% inclination unto lotus feet of Krishna is a pivoted quality, pivoted, centered point. If all other 24 qualities are there, but Krishnaika Saran, the Saranagati is not there, all other 25 qualities can be compared with some material qualities, not transcendental qualities. So the place where you cannot get the scope to see and to get the association of pure devotees, darshan, you should not stay there. Again, it is written in Bhagavatam, Nayatro Yogya Samakha Mahasabha, where there is not Sankirtan Jagya. In general, it is written Jagya, but we Gauriya can mean Sankirtan Jagya. Nayatro Yogya Samakha Mahasabha, but Harinam Sankirtan Jagya is topmost Jagya. It can give the facility of dhyan. It can give the facility of jagya. It can give the facility of archan. It can give the facility of everything. All advantage we can get, Prabhupada speaking, all square advantage. All square facility we can get by Harinam Sankirtan Jagya. Sankirtanaika Pitarau. Gaur Nityananda Prabhu is a Pitarau. You know, Divachan in Sanskrit, we have two, Gaur Nityananda, about both of them. So, na yatra vaikuntha katha sudhapaga, na sadhava bhagavata tadasraya, na yatra yogyesa makha mahatsava suresa loko opi na vaisa sebhatam. If it is heavenly planet controlled by Indra Maharaj, still I cannot go there. If it is controlled by Indra Maharaj, if it is heavenly planet, still I don't like to go there. If there is no facility to hear Harikatha from a pure Guru Vaishnava, no facility to get the association of pure devotees, those who are having 100% inclination unto lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan, where there is no Jagya Mahatsav, big festival, big Mahatsav, not there, we cannot go there. So, this is one kind of, you know, bhakti anukul matra kajyaro sikha. Daino atma nivedan, six kind of saranagati, you know already. I can discuss all in details if the time permits someday, not now. Daino atma nivedan, daino, you know, you already know, you are habitual to hear Harikatha. Daino atma nivedan, Daino, humbleness, Trinadabhi, which is the basic thing. If you pass remark that Keshav Goswami is speaking very hard, so no Trinadabhi there. If you say Santo Goswami Maharaj, no Trinadabhi, they are speaking very heavily, then you are going to make aparad. You can fall down. So this way, who is Trinadabhi, who is not, this way you cannot pass remarks. Who can pass remark? Who can pass remark about pure Vaishnava? About pure Guru Vaishnava, who can pass remark? Some bandit soul, they are making some committee and society, they can pass remark? About who is Vaishnava, who is not Vaishnava? Who can pass remark? Who is Vaishnava and who is not Vaishnava? Who can pass remark? Simply because you are making one big society, you have human, many men power and money powers, you can pass? How dare you pass this kind of remark? No Siddhanta Vichar, you know. Nothing. Daino Atma Nivedan Goptitya Varan. Daino Atma Nivedan. Daino humbleness. Atma Nivedan. Surrender. Goptitya Varan. Krishna can protect me. Rakha. And what is favorable, I can, bhakti anukul matra kajya jishikar, bhakti patikul, I can discard. All the dainya atma nivedan, gaptitya badan, avasya rakhiben Krishna. Surely Krishna can give protection. Whole world can go against me. Still they cannot do anything against me. Because those sadhus, those who are in favor of absolute truth, it is the responsibility of Nityananda Balaram, Nishingadev to protect them. Nobody can do any harm. By chance they can try to stop Harikatha, they can go against him, they can speak all rubbish against him, but finally they cannot come out successful. Follow? So, Bhakti Yunudik 6, Bhakti Dainya Atma Nivedan Gaptitya Varan, Avasya Rakhivan Krishna, surely Krishna can give protection. Bhakti Anugul Matya Kajyaja Sikar, Bhakti Padikul Kajyo Bhajjanangikar, Saranga Saranagade, six kind of inclination, if not there, if you depend upon your money power, bank balance, you have collected so many money from foreign country, in the name of preaching, Prabhupada speaking, it is karma. Prabhupada speaking, it is karma. It is not our target. It is not our target to collect huge amount of money. It is not our target to collect huge amount of money unnecessarily. In that case, we can develop money power and we can ignore, we can insult Guru Vaishnava. That much facility we can get. So, this way, Bhakti Anukul, regarding which place we should live, regarding that, this sloka I already told you. Remember about you. If only Krishna Leela is there, no Ram Leela is there, then thousands of billions of common people, they cannot understand Krishna Leela properly. So Ram Leela, that kind of ethical character, that kind of morality, that kind of, you know, dutifulness, you cannot find in Krishna Leela. Krishna Leela, Krishna, we common people cannot worship Krishna. We cannot do bhajan of Krishna. We can try. We can at least try, we cannot do Krishna Bhajan properly. Because for Krishna Bhajan we need one thing. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Kam Beech Kam Mantra Jar Aradhan. Only by the help of Kam Beech and Kam Mantra, Kam Gayatri. Kam Gayatri Kam Beech Jar Aradhan. Only by the help of Kam Gayatri and Kam Beech it is possible for me to worship Krishna, to love Krishna, to do serve Krishna. Otherwise not. Prabhupada speaking, somebody worshipping inside temple, there is a deity of Radha Krishna, Radha Gopinath, Gaurari, everything there. If the pujari coming out, if you put question, you are doing worship of whom? You are doing worship of Krishna. Yes, I am doing worship Krishna. Prabhupada speaking, no. He is going inside temple to worship Krishna, but due to Aishwarya Gyan, he is not devoid of Aishwarya Gyan. So his bhakti become Lakshmi Narayan bhakti. There is no surety that they can do Krishna bhakti. They cannot so. But Krishna, so long as you are going to fill appliances, I mean, Aishwarya Bhav, till then you cannot step into Krishna Bhajan. Krishna Bhajan not possible. When all your material designation, material titles, everything gone away, when your Atma, heart can realize, Gapi Bhartur Padakamalyor Daso Dasanu Dasaha, I am the servant of the servant of the servant of Gapi Bhartur Padakamalyor Daso Dasanu Dasaha. You can feel rasatatta totally, you know, different rasatatta there. So kam gayatri kam bij jararadhan. Those who are kam gayatri kam bij, they are actually can worship Nandanandan Krishna, Brajanandan Krishna. Aradha Bhagavan Vajasasthanayasta Dhamma Vrindavanam Ramya Kachid Basana Bajabadi Vargena Jakalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Prema Pamartha Mahano Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Matam Idam Tatradarana Para. So you see the qualification and quality I already discussed for a long time, just 3-4 months before. So only and only those who are depending upon Kam Gayatri Kam Bij, each and every word, each and every syllable of Kam Gayatri can so indicate the charming, you know, quality of Krishna, the charming, you know, beautiful feature of Krishna. They are only and only they can do. Otherwise, our bhajan can maximum become Lakshmi Narayan bhajan. So be careful. I never like to cheat you. That's why you all become angry with me, because I don't like to cheat you. So kam gayatri kam mantra, if only Krishna bhajan is there, then people, common people, they could not get chance to go through Ramlila. It's very important. Common people, those who are not going in deep, they cannot understand Krishna Lila. So better they can go through Ramlila. The pathetic life history of Ramlila, Ramji Maharaj, can put some impact inside their heart, and they can change their heart. At least they can follow the ethical character and dutifulness, all humbleness, all everything of Ramchandra. Now I can try to discuss something about Ramlila, but before that I was starting with one sloka spoken by Hanumanji Maharaj, which is very important. Before starting the Harikatha, I was bound to speak one sloka, which is by Hanumanji Maharaj. Na janamanu nam mahato na sovagam na bhangna buddhir nakritito sohetuhu toirjadvisishtannopi navano kasaha chakara sakshyavato lakshanagraja. What is the meaning? Hanumanji Maharaj, out of his humble attitude, About Hanumanji Maharaj it is written, Ganinam Barishtam Manojavam Maruti Tullavegam Jitendriyam Buddhimatam Barishtam Bhatatmajam Banarayuto Muksham Siram Dutam Tamaham Smarami Namami. Manojavam Maruti Tullavegam Jitendriyam Buddhimatam Barishtam. Those who are Ganinam Barishtam, those who are knowledgeable personality, Tattva Gyani, is a very, very high class, topmost, Hanumanji Maharaj. But externally, he is showing that I am beast. I am Hanuman. I am beast. So, how I can get the keep of Ramchandra? After that, he is going to give answer. Surely, if somebody is going to demand, I have taken birth in a high family, so I can get the kippa of Ramchandra. Not that. Hanumanji Maharaj is going to clarify this point. In which race you have taken birth, which family life you have taken birth, which family heritage you have taken birth, it's not a big issue. It matters little. How handsome, how beautiful you are looking, it's not a big issue. It is not a big factor that how much education, how much panditta, how great pandit you are or not, how much educational qualification you have, that's not a big factor. It's not a big issue. Na janma nuna mahato na saubhagam. And you can speak nicely, and without any bhakti, somebody can try to glorify Harikatha. But it is not actually Harikatha. So, na janma nunam mahato na saubhagam. So, Kunti Devi also speaking this way. Kunti Devi, Kunti Devi. that I have educational qualification, I have taken birth in a high family, I am very good looking, I am Pandit, you know, very good looking, very Pandit. It, all those points are very, very not, very important points. Those points are not so important. So, Hanumanji Maharaj speaking, if those are the main factors on the basis of which, if those are the main factors on the basis of which Ramchandra going to keep kripa to everybody, then Hanumanji Maharaj speaking, then surely in the list you cannot find my name, because I am Pashu, I am beast, I am very bad looking, I have no educational qualification, I am not good looking, I am not taken birth in a high family, nothing. Then how it is possible for Ramchandra, Lakshanagraja, I mean the elder brother of Lakshmanji Maharaj, how it is possible that the elder brother of Lakshmanji Maharaj going to give kripa on me? How possible? This Lakshan directly not going to speak Ram. Here is one indication. Lakshman is Jagat Guru, at the same time Bhagavat Tattva. So Sukadev Goswami, Vyasadev Goswami and Sukadev Goswami wanted to give indication that Guru Vina Bhavanidika Taraina Koi Ram Kipabinuttar Sulavana Swai. Indication. Otherwise, directly the name of Ramchandra could speak. Hanumanji Maharaj going to speak the name of Ramchandra, through the link of Lakshmanji Maharaj. Through this one kind of technique through which Hanumanji Maharaj wanted to prove that without Guru, nobody can reach Ramji Maharaj. First of all, we should get the kripa of Lakshman, then the question of getting the lotus feet of Ramchandra coming. I can go back to Ramayana to speak one incident. Bali Maharaj is very powerful. Bali Maharaj. Bali and Sugriv, they are both two brothers. They are all married. But Sugriv is not so powerful. So every day Baliji Maharaj is going to beat him and throw him. It's very painful situation. Painful situation. He was successful to make a friendship with Hanumanji Maharaj and ultimately with Ramji Maharaj. Anyway, so Sugriv Ji Maharaj getting, Sugriv Ji Maharaj always getting tortured from elder brother Sugriv, Bali. So one day Sugriv Ji Maharaj is speaking to Ramchandra, Prabhu, You already promised me that you can save me. But repeatedly, Bali going to my elder brother, going to beat me all the time unnecessarily, going to abduct my wife. You are not speaking anything. Ramji Maharaj speaking, you see, there is no procedure that you can come to me directly. So why not you go to Lakshmanji Maharaj first? You go to Lakshman, take shelter there. Then Lakshman can allow you to come to me. Then I can give you full protection. Otherwise not. This is the system. This is the system actually. So, by this sloka, Hanumanji Maharaj wanted to give indication that by the help, by the kripa of Lakshmanji Maharaj, it is possible to get the kripa of Sri Ramchandra. Still today, Hanumanji Maharaj acting as Acharya. Hanumanji Maharaj has his eternal sarup in Abodh, Ayodhapuri. Hanumanji Maharaj surely having his eternal sarup in, but still, like Uddhavji Maharaj. Uddhavji Maharaj eternal sarup there in Krishna Lila, at the same time, Uddhavji Maharaj also they are doing bhajan in Badrikasram, also doing bhajan in Uddhav Kundo, Uddhav Kunda in Vrindavan, Govardhan, Uddhav Kunda, they are also doing bhajan. This way, according to the instruction of Bhagavan, they are doing bhajan. Hanumanji Maharaj also doing bhajan. Hanumanji Maharaj, in this, here, King Purusha Varsha, our total Indian land divided into different parts, King Purush, Ajanava Varsha, all different, you know, Bharat Varsha, all, Jambudip divided into different parts. So here it is written in 5th canto, Sukhda Goswami speaking, King Purushe Varshe Bhagavantam Adi Purusham Lakshmana Grajam Siddhaviramam Ramam Tacharano Sanni Karsa Virataha Paramo Bhagavato Hanuman Saho King Purushai Ravirata Bhakti Rupaste King Purusha Varshe King Purushe Varshe King Purushe Varshe Bhagavantam Adipurusham Lakshanagrajam I mean Ramchandra Sitaviramam Ramam Tacharano Sanni Karsaviratha Paramo Bhagavata Hanuman Hanumanji Maharaj doing bhajan in King Purusha Varsha with all Arishya Sen together with Arishya Sen all of Gandharva they are doing chanting and singing song and dancing all the time. Through when I can start Bhagavatamrita, there I can discuss how beautiful Hanumanji Maharaj dancing and Brihad Bhagavatamrita, maybe next Harikatha I can start, I can announce. So, Arishta Senena Saho Gandharvai Rupagiyya Manam Param Kalyanim Bhartir Bhagavata Katham Samupos Srinoti Sayam Chedam Gayati. Together with Arishta Sen, Hanumanji Maharaj singing this sloka and chanting Ram, Ram, Jai Ram, Si Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Jai Ram, Si Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Jai Ram, Si Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Jai Ram, Si Ram, Jai Jai Ram. This way they are chanting. And what is the sloka? Om Namo Bhagavate Uttama Slokayo Namo Arjo Lakshana Silo Bratayo Namo Upo Shikshitatmano Upasito Lokayo Namaha Sadubado Nikosanayo Namo Brahmano Devayo Mahapurushayo Maharajayo Namo Iti. What is the sloka? But it is written, Hanumanji Maharaj singing this sloka. Om Namo Bhagavate Uttama Slokayo. Uttama Slokayo means, who is being worshipped by Uttama Sloka. Nice, nice sloka. Uttamai Slokate. Iti Uttama Sloko. Or, Tamo Udgato Yasmat Iti Uttamaha. Tamo Udgato, there is no Tamo Rajagun, pure Satagun, those who are sadhu, they are making nice, nice sloka to glorify. To glorify Bhagavan Ramchandra. So, Om Namo Bhagavate Uttama Slokayo Namo Arjo Lakshana Slir Shila Vratayo Namo Upo Shikshitatmano Upasito Lokayo Namaha Sadhu Bado Nika Nikasanayo Namo Brahmanna Devayo Mahapurushayo Maharajayo Namo Iti. Through the sloka, Hanumanji Maharaj want to speak very nice. The Arjo Silo Bratayo, the kind of tenderness, humbleness, you know, Guruvanugatha, the kind of softness, sophisticated behavior, you know, is impossible. If we don't have the chance to go through Ramlila, we cannot understand. So, Arjo Lakshana Silo Bratayo. The sloka, I read total sloka, Om Namo Bhagavate, Om Namo Bhagavate, Uttama Slokayo, Namo Arjo Lakshano Shilo Bratayo. Arjo means those who are topmost, very nice among those who are, you know, following Veda, those who are Arja. Arja means Sesto. Among them, Ramchandra is topmost. Arjo Lakshana Silo Vratayo. Going to follow all the rules and etiquette, humbleness, dutifulness, all everything. You know, all is going to keep promise, everything. Arjo Silo Vratayo Namaha. Who is going to teach us by the help of his own character? By the help of his own character and etiquette, he is going to show public, and public going to worship him by watching the sophisticated behavior of Ramchandra. They always worship him, love him. So this way, Brahmana Devaya, those who are going to give full protection to Brahman Vaishnava, who is the source of all Kalyan, Mangal, you know, Brahmana Devaya, Mahapurushaya, Maharajaya Namaha. Jai Jai Raghupati Raja Ram, Patita Pavana Sitaram. This way, this sloka going to Hanumanji speaking to glorify the excellent glory of Ramchandra. Now, we will have to discuss some point, how then I can go back to Srimad Bhagavaji Mahapuran 11th canto, where we can get that gradually Navajogendra going to speak about the Kalikal Bhajan and different yuga, what is the symptom of Bhagavan, all these things. And in the meanwhile, actually, are going to speak about which I am speaking before starting Harikatha, I am speaking every day. Dheyam sada paribhavagnam avishtadoham tirthas padam siva virinchinutam saranyam bhiktartiham pranatapal bhavadipotam bande mahapurusate charanaravindam. Bande mahapurusate charanaravindam. All the time. Deyam sada, we should meditate unto the lotus feet of this sloka, Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking. Especially this sloka is meant for both Ram and Krishna. Bhagavan Sri Krishna and Ramchandra, both of them mean. But those who are Gauriya devotee, they can also get some nice meaning. But who is Krishna? Who is Krishna Chaitanya? Someday, if I can get scope to discuss about Gaurlila, Gaur Tattva, then I can show by the help of this sloka. Vishwanath Chakravarti is going to discuss all in details, that those Gauriya, they can prove this sloka is spoken for Gauranga Mahaprabhu also. So those who are worshipping Ramchandra, especially they are going to apply for their own benefit for Ramchandra Bhajan. Those who are going to do Krishna Bhajan, they are also going to use it. And especially Vishwanath Chakravarti, we are going to prove that this is also applicable for Gaurchandra. Someday I can discuss, not today. So you see, Deyam Sada, we should meditate. It is really, of course, the topmost object of worship and meditation. Deyam Sada Paribhavagna, which can erase, which can eliminate all material problem for our life in the way of our spiritual development. All different kind of material problem can come, it can erase. Paribhavagna bhavishta doham. And those who are common people, material people, they avishta mean target. So common people, their target is money, position, woman, this target. Prabhupada speaking, this should not be our target. Avishta mean, we are going to expect to get something out of our effort. We are putting some effort for some reason, are going to get something, some result. is called Avishto. But Prabhupada speaking, material people, their Avishto is very dirty. Avishto, this word, we cannot use. Because material desire, material sense gratification should not be our Avishto. Because Avi, Pro, Para, Apo, Onu, this in Bhakaran, Sanskrit Bhakaran, Avishto. You know? So, Dheyam Sada Paribhavagna Avishto Duham Tirthas Padam is the Tirtha, is the pilgrimage of all pilgrimage. All the power of pilgrimage coming from the lotus feet of Ramchandra and all his devotees. Like you can remember, Vidurji Maharaj was heavily insulted by Duryodhan. So he went to different pilgrimage. When he came back to meet Panchapandav, there Yudhishthir Maharaj Singh. Well, you are actually yourself one pilgrimage. Tirthi kurvanti tirthani shantasthena gadabhritaha. Gadabhrita Bhagavan, Supreme Lord is confined. Supreme Lord is confined inside your heart. So anywhere you go, that place become nice pilgrimage. Because Bhaktir Hidaya Sada Govinda Vishwam. Inside the heart, Bhaktir Hidaya Sada, inside the heart of devotees, Krishna Govinda always taking rest. That's why whenever we find pure devotees, that place becomes big pilgrimage. Because Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking to Vidurji Maharaj, when Vidur Maharaj come back from his pilgrimage, speaking, Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani Santasthena Gadabhritaha. So you are going to Tirtha. Why you are going to Tirtha? Because we know you are going to Tirtha to recharge Tirtha. Those who are material people, those sinful activities going on in Tirtha, who can recharge? Bhagavan cannot come. Those pure devotees, they can come to Tirtha to recharge that pilgrimage and give power. So, Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishto Deham. Deyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishto Doham. Tirthaspadam Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam. Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam. Hanumanji Maharaj coming from Mahadev. And Jambuvanji Maharaj coming from Brahma, avatar. So Siva Virinchinutam Saranyam. Those Brahma, Sankar going to take shelter onto whose lotus feet? That is called Ram, Rama, Viramam, Bhuyo, Bhuyo, Namamiham. Apadam, Apahartaram, Dataram, Sarvasampadam. Rama Viramam Bhuyo Bhuyo Namamyaham Arbhittartiham. All different kind of painful situation of devotees, immediately Bhagavan going to take step to take them out of painful situation. Bhittartiham Bhitto Artiham. If they are at all pain giving some, if at all they are getting some pain, immediately Bhagavan can take them out of pain. Painful situation. Bhittatiham pranatapalo. Those who are going to take shelter unto Ram, immediately it is the promise, it is the resolution of Ramchandra to protect him. Etat brahbhato, etat brahtomamo. Those who are going to speak, Ram, I am your. The day one Jivatma going to speak, Ram, I am your. From then onward, Ram speaking, it is my promise, I am going to protect you, giving him protection. Follow. Bhirtatiham pranagopal bhavadipotam. Bhavadipotam. Bhavadipotam means to cross over this material ocean, we need one boat or ship. To cross over this material ocean, we need one boat or ship. So Ramchandra's lotus feet is like our boat. We can take shelter of Ramchandra. We can cross over this material ocean very easily. Bande Mahapurushate, Bande Mahapurushate, Charunarvindam. Vedartiham. So this way, in general, I am going to discuss, not in details. And the next slok also applicable for Ramchandra. What is the next slok? First slok I discuss. What is this? I start from Dheyam Dheyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishtaduham. Dheyam Dheyam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishtaduham. Tethas Padam Siva Virenchunutam Saranyam. Bhirtatiham Pranotapal Bhavadipotam. Bande Mahapurusate Charna Ravindam. Stakpa Dustajya Surefsi Torajya Lakshim. Dharmishta Arja Vachasa Jadaka Dharanyam. Maya migam daitepsitam badhavado bande mahapurusate charana rabindam. Taktva, living all sudustajyo, impossible to avoid this kind of affluences, rajalakshi, impossible to avoid this kind of rajalakshi affluences, impossible. So, stakva sudustajam surepsito rajya lakshim. Even Indra Maharaj, Varun Maharaj, they are always expecting this kind of affluences, but not getting. You can also remember, Bali Maharaj was given more and more affluences than heavenly planet where our Indra staying. Shutal, down, you know, atal, vital, talatal, rasatal, sutal, tal, bhur, bhuva, swa, maho, yano, tapo, shatto, up, and down seven lok, all 14 worlds. Follow what I say. This way, all, you know, those who are living in heavenly planet, those who are demigods, like Indra, Varun, they are also expecting this kind of appliances, but not getting. This kind of appliances were there naturally with Ramchandra, because he is Supreme Lord. How we can compare Ramchandra with Indra Maharaj? Impossible. Stakta sudustajya surepsito. Shura ipsito. Ipsito means banchito. Those who are demigods, they are expecting this kind of surepsito rajyalakshim. This kind of big appliances, Rajya Lakshim. And Dharmishtho, there is very pious. They are going to give value to any Dharma Bhakya. In toto, Ramchandra going to follow. Krishna Bhagavan can speak this and do something else. Kapat. Okay. There is also sweetness there, but in general I am explaining. Krishna can play with me. Krishna can make a joking, can throw me, but Ramchandra cannot do it. Ramchandra, Dharmishtho, is very pious, and Dharma, Adharma, na dharma, na dharmam. Raghunath Das Goswami is speaking. Someday I can discuss. Dharma, Adharma, don't play your head over that if you like to do Krishna Bhajan. Whatever Krishna doing, all full of rasa, everything all okay. You cannot find fault with Krishna. Whatever Krishna doing, whatever arrangement done by Krishna is all good. But Ramchandra is going to justice, is a symbol of justice. Even a street dog can get justice from Ramchandra. Follow. About Bhagavan Sri Krishna, we should not expect, because this is the area of rasa tattva. Aslishava padaratam pinastumam adarshanad marmatam kartuva jatha tathava vidudhatulam padamatpananasasu swayavan. Krishna can throw me out. Krishna can cheat me. Krishna can block me. Krishna can do anything. Whatever behavior, still I love Krishna. Hatena kenapi satena brajavadu bitena is, you know, who speaking, you know, Billamangal Thakur. Someday I can discuss. So Krishna Bhajan, if you are doing Krishna Bhajan, you should not have any complaint. If somebody going to go against, if somebody going against me, if somebody say the behavior of Sam Baba is not good, if somebody say okay, he is very good, anything they are passing the mind. But I am not going to feel any problem. Because no, in material world, people can pass remark. But I will have to think about that absolute truth. I cannot give satisfaction to you. I am trying to give satisfaction to Supreme Lord. So if Ramlila is there, not there, is big problem. Common, ordinary people, they can at least watch Ramlila, can get some reaction also, Ramlila, very plain. And Dharmishtha, very pious, and going to follow Dharma in toto. Through this word Dharmishtha, going to indicate that Ramchandra wanted to fulfill the promise of Dasarath. Dasarath promised to Kaikeyi that I can give you three boon, benediction. But on time when Kaikeyi going to get boon from Dasarathji Maharaj, one boon is that my son Bharat will be king of Ayodhya. Second boon, Ramchandra should go away in forest. You know, this way different kind of. But actually there is some mystery. I was also speaking in Hindi Harikatha. There is one kind of mystery there. Outside people cannot understand. Outside people cannot understand that why Gauranga going to leave Vishnupriya. Impossible. Somebody going to speak all Ravi Singh and Gauranga, they have no idea about it. Somebody going to speak all Ravi Singh and Kaikeyi, why Kaikeyi going to ask this kind of benediction? Merciless! No man, no. There is some secrecy. There is some secrecy. There is some commentary where you can find Kaikeyi. Actually Ramchandra took birth in the lap of Kaushalya Nandan. But Ramchandra getting more and more love from Kaikeyi. How it is possible for Kaikeyi to play this kind of politics? Impossible. Then what is the truth? Point is that one day Ramchandra going to speak something secret to Kaikeyi. Ma, you love me. You are ready to give everything. Yes. I am going to live even my life for you. No, I don't lead your life. I am going to ask something from you. If you promise me, you can agree to give me. Oh, what you speak out? No. First of all, you will have to promise me that you can keep your promise, then I can speak. Well, now you speak. Three benediction, three boon due with your husband, I mean my father, Dasarathji Maharaj. Now it is the proper time you can ask. You can beg for pardon. What is this? You will have to send me to forest. What? Yes, you will have to send me to forest. You will have to arrange, you will have to speak that Bharat will be the king of Ayodhya. You will have to ask. I cannot ask. You promise me. You promise me you cannot break. Everybody all over the world, whole creation can hate you. How much pressure can come on you, that I know. But if you love me, you will have to bear it. Everybody can hate you. That Kaikeyi is going to send Ram in forest, merciless. But I know how much merciful you are. If you are not going to beg this kind of benediction from Bun, from Dasarath, then I cannot. The reason for why I am coming here in this material planet, I cannot come out successful. You will have to beg. So Kaikeyi was bound to ask. So Ramchandra for 14 years was sent to exile, and in forest there were so many big problem. Ram Lakshmanji Maharaj also going with Ramchandra and Sita Devi speaking, my husband is Ram, I cannot stay without Ram, I can go with my husband. So three of them going in forest, they are leading a very painful life, and Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran also it is written that people can think that for killing all rakshas, those who are rakshas, to kill them, Ramchandra came in this material world. Not that. Somebody can speak only to kill those, you know, demons and, you know, rakshas, Ramchandra came. Taraka Rakshasi, everything. Follow. But actually not that. There is some other reason, secret reason. If Bhagavan Ramchandra not going to this kind of Martha Leela, human-like Leela, then who is going to feel inspiration? Who is going to? So, Sukhdev Goswami writing that Martha Avataru Tu Iho Martha Shikshanam. This kind of human Leela done by Ramchandra to teach us how you should lead ideal life, idealism, what kind of idealism, what kind of ethical character, what kind of dutifulness, what kind of dharma should be there in your life, to teach all these things, Ramchandra coming. Martha avataratiho martha shikshanam raksho badhayo Raksho badayayubo na kevalam vibho. Not only to kick rakshas and demons. This is not the reason for why Ramchandra coming. Martavatvarutviho marto shikshanam. Martavatvarutviho marto shikshanam raksho badayaibo na kevalam vibhu kuto annatha shad ramataha sha atmanaha sita kritani vyasanani ishvaraswa. Like ordinary human being, Ramchandra crying for Sita. Oh, Sita, crying. Why? Like human being. A painful separation. Like human being, ordinary. But actually, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, Sita Kritani Vasanani Kuto Ishvaraswa. How it is possible that Ramchandra, the Supreme Lord, can cry like a child, like a human being for Sita? It's impossible. Where from? Because he is Supreme Lord. But he is doing this kind of Leela just like ordinary human being. Kuto annatha swad ramataha swa atmanaha sita kritani vyasanani ishvaraswa. How possible? You can remember, on those days, those who are big king, famous king, they used to go to their country people. They, in guise of ordinary man, on those days, like Prahlad Maharaj, Yudhishthira Maharaj, Ramchandra, Janak Maharaj, they usually used to go outside in the guise of ordinary men to watch the situation of the country, to understand the deficiency of common public, to satisfy their demand. What is the problem there in the country? They usually hearing from mantri, minister, they usually hearing all information. They are taking information from different ministers, but sometimes they are directly going in the guise of ordinary people. So Ramchandra Bhagavan also going in the market, village and city, in the guise of ordinary men. One day Ramchandra, while passing through one house, the householder speaking to wife heavily, "Hey, I am not Ram." So that Sita going to the house of Ravan, still Ramchandra going to accept Sita. "I am not going to accept you again, because you gone to somebody's house. I cannot accept you again. I am not Ram. So that Sita gone to the country of Ravan. Sita gone to the country of Ravan. Still, who knows what happened? So Ramchandra is going to accept Sita, but in place of Ramchandra, I am not going to accept you. Then Ramchandra thinking, well, the ordinary people, they misunderstand me. I know Sita is totally pure and chaste lady. Impossible, Sita cannot grow any contamination. But still, there's common public, they are growing false conception. So I must take step according to that. So Ramchandra coming back to his own kingdom, own palace, and giving order to all ministers and Lakshman that there should be one fire sacrifice where my wife Sita Devi can enter into fire. If fire not going to burn her, then I'm sure she is pure and chaste. Though internally I know that she is chaste lady, but still, common people, to stop common people thinking wrong, I'll have to do it this way. One time Agni Parikha, fire test. Second time again fire test. But Sita Devi could not bear again. That is after, long time after. And also Sita Devi was sent to forest Vishwamitra Muni. There Sita Devi was, she was sent by Lakshman. She was sent to forest by Ramchandra. You know, by the help of Lakshmanji Maharaj. Lakshmanji going, and Sita Devi was left at Vishwamitra Ashram. There Lav and Kush, two sons. There is so many, you know, two twine boys taking birth, somebody speaking, and some other conception also going on. I don't like to fight. Only the reason for why I want to show these topics, and discuss these topics, to show you how Ramchandra is very careful about, you know, at the duty as a king, as a pious king. As a pious king, what is the duty of Ramchandra? He is going to show us. He is going to give value to the conception of common people. He is going to take steps so that common people cannot misunderstand him. It's a big issue. And after that, you know, 60,000 years Ramchandra, you know, controlling his kingdom, everything. But after, first of all, Bharatji Maharaj was given, and this sloka going to speak, stakta dustajya surakshito rajya lakshim dharmishto arjya vachasa. Here this sloka meaning, dharmishto meaning is very pious. He is going to, in toto, he is going to follow Dharma. And Arjo Bachasa, Arjamin, is a very famous man, Dasaraji Maharaj, who is Arjo. And Arjamin, those who are following Veda, and very important personality, they are Arjo. Famous man, Arjo. And Arjo Bachasa means, because Dasaraji Maharaj promised to give benediction to Kaikeyi, so according on the basis of that, Ramji Maharaj, to fulfill the desire of father, to keep the commitment of father, he is going away to forest. Dharmishto Arjo Vachasa, jad agad aranyam, jad agad, agad means already gone to forest, to lead painful life, a forest life. Follow. And this sloka applicable for Ramchandra, because Maya megam daitav sitam vadhavada. Here is written. Stakpa sudustajyo surepsito rajya lakshim dharmishto arjya vachasa jatagadharanyam. Maya megam daitav sitam vadhavada bande mahapurusate charanarvindam. What is written? Maya megam. You know very well, you have basic conception of Ramayana. While Ramji Maharaj was in exile, one day Marich came and in the guise of beautiful golden deer. Marich came by the inspiration of Ravan came. Marich was killed. Also Khar Dushan, the brother of Ravan, was also killed by Ram. But the point is that Ramchandra, by the desire of Sita Devi in Bhajan Kutir, speaking, "Ho Prabhu, I like to get this golden deer. I like to keep that deer as a pet deer. I like to keep pet deer. You please catch that deer." By the desire of Sita Devi, Ramchandra was bound to go behind Maya Mingo Daitya Sitam. Maharaj, Ramchandra is Bhagavan. He cannot understand. It is Maya. Ramchandra, no. But is doing just like, acting like ordinary human being. By the desire and request of Sita Devi, Ramchandra running behind that deer to catch the deer so that Sita Devi can keep that deer with her, running. So this is applicable for Ramchandra also. So Maya Migam Daitav Sitam Madhavada Annadhavada. Maya Migam Daitav Sitam Madhavada. By the desire of Sita running behind, in knowing everything, that is Maya. In that case, Ramchandra knows it for sure, it is Maya, but what to do? He loves Sita. Also, there is one kind of beautiful Leela. If Ram not going, how Ravan can come to abduct Sita? There is one kind of Leela. There has to be there. So now, Ramchandra giving instruction to Lakshman. Lakshman, I am going, but you don't go. You stay here. After some time, Marich, that deer actually Rakshas. That Rakshas Marich coming in the form of deer, golden deer. That Marich crying just like Ramchandra. Those who are Asur, they have some magic spell. They can shout like you, same tone like Ramchandra. They can take the form of Ramchandra, they can do. Those who are Rakshas, they have some Maya Vidya. So Marich understand that Ramchandra can kill me. And Marich running. And to put in confusion, Marich shouting like Ram. Ah! As if Ramchandra in trouble. Then Sita Devi naturally asking Lakshman, maybe your elder brother Ram is in problem. You go immediately. Then Lakshman speaking, it is quite impossible that my brother Ram can be in problem. No! He is in problem, you run immediately. He is in problem, you cannot hear his voice. No! Ram can never be in problem. Ramchandra is, because Lakshman knows the tattva of Ramchandra. But what to do? Repeatedly speaking, when Lakshman not at all ready to go, then Sita Devi speaking, well, for me you are not going away, for me. Then Lakshman was shocked, because Lakshman never look the face of Sita Devi. Always looking the lotus feet of Sita Devi. And Sita Devi to push him away, she was bound to speak that way. Then Lakshmanji Maharaj ultimately took decision. Well, I am going because you are giving instruction, but don't go out of this marking with arrow. With arrow, Lakshman making one boundary. Out of this boundary, please, it is my request, you don't go. I am going in search of my brother. Because you are giving me order, so Lakshman gone. In the meantime, Rakshas Ravan coming to abduct Sita. Bhiksham Dehi, Bhiksham Dehi. Sita Devi coming out of Bhajan Kutir. Oh, there is one sannyasi. He is begging for bhiksha. Sita Devi is speaking, well, wait, I can give you bhiksha. Some fruits and rice going to give. But Ravan speaking, no, I cannot take bhiksha from inside boundary. It is derogatory. It is insulting for me. I am sannyasi. If you at all like to give me bhiksha, you have to come out of this boundary, then and only then I can get bhiksha, otherwise I am going away. You are leading grihastha life. Grihastha life can meet with amangal if I am going away. The Ravan was about to go away, then Sita, wait, I am going to give you bhiksha. Then Sita Devi crossing the boundary, and as soon as going to cross the boundary to give bhiksha, Ravan arrest Sita Devi and ha 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 laughing like rakshas and going to catch Sita Devi and put in chariot and going to fly towards Lanka. In the meantime, Jatayu, the friend of Dasaraji Maharaj, he was there. Jatayu was bound to fight with Ravan up to his last limit. After that, he was failure because Ravan was very powerful. One wing was cut off by Ravan, a fall down, and waiting to meet with Ram to give the information that your Siddha abducted by Ravan. Here one Gauriya Siddhanta I like to speak. Some question can come, how it is possible for Ravan. How it is possible for Ravan to abduct Sita. Sita is Sarup Shakti. Sarup Shakti, except Bhagavan himself, nobody can touch Sarup Shakti. Sarup Shakti is the personal property of Supreme Lord. Like Radharani can never touch anybody except Krishna, Nandanandan Krishna. And Ramchandra, except Ramchandra, Sita Devi cannot touch. But how it is possible? This Siddhanta I can clarify. Then I can go on discussing some point to speak the glories of Bhagavan Sri Krishna and Ramchandra. If I don't discuss this point, you can misunderstand Krishna. So I'll have to discuss. Anyway, so externally we find Sita Devi was abducted by Ravan, but actually not so. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, we can find when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to South India, one Ram Bhaji Vipra, one Brahman, is doing bhajan of Ramchandra. He one day wanted to give bhiksha to sannyasi Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sannyasi, she wanted to give bhiksha. But the Brahman not cooking. Then Mahaprabhu around 12 o'clock asking, hey, you invite me, why not cooking? Actually Ramchandra now staying in exile. So at present there is no market. So Lakshman gone for collecting fruits and flower from forest. And when Lakshman can come back, then and only then Sita Devi can cook. Then Mahaprabhu was very happy. Mahaprabhu was very happy to see the mood of that Brahman. Mahaprabhu was very happy to see the mood of that Brahman, his Rambhajan. Very happy. Very happy. Now, after some day, Mahaprabhu gone. You know, after that, you know, one Brahman is speaking one day when that Sita Devi was abducted by Ravan, I cannot bear. I'll have to throw my body into fire. Then Mahaprabhu speaking, no, impossible. Sita Devi is Sarup Shakti of Ram. How it is possible for Ram to abduct Sita? But it is written in Raman. It is written in Ravan. But the secret things nobody knows. When Ravan came to abduct Sita, Sita Devi took shelter of Agni, Agan fire. So by the help of Agni, by the help of Agnidev, Agnidev going to make such a puppet, like puppet, one kind of light magic, light, like electrical magic, like light magic, you know, it's like Sita, but it's not actually Sita. They are going to make one Sita, duplicate Sita, an actual Sita going under the shelter of Agnidev. Nobody knows. When Mahaprabhu went to South Indian tour, one place, there, one river, Suparno, what name I forget actually, at the bank of that river, those Brahman, they are reading Kurma Puran. They are reading all different Kurma Puran and this, you know, Tamraparni river. At the bank of that, some Brahman there have some society. They are every day they are reading different kind of Purans and everything. So in that Puran, Mahaprabhu here, that as soon as Ravan wanted to abduct Sita, Sita went in the shelter of Agni, fire, and Agnidev going to give duplicate Sita forward, and Ravan was bound to abduct duplicate Sita. So original Sita was there with Agnidev, but this is one kind of Leela. Like you can remember the Leela, Urvashi wanted to cheat Pururava. Urvashi wanted to cheat Purureva. So Urvashi gone away, and Purureva like mad searching in illusion. Ultimately, Gandharva, they wanted to cheat Pururava. They gain one kind of duplicate Urvashi, so that Pururava can play with her this way. Ultimately, Pururava could discover this magic spell, and crying and speaking very, very, very nice Siddhanta Vichar. Now, similarly, in Aprakita Jagat, what is possible, what is not possible, if you argue, to start argument, you cannot get satisfaction. So this way, Ravan saw duplicate Sita, so duplicate Sita was abducted. So duplicate Sita was abducted by Ravan, so actual Sita was not there. Still, to do this kind of Leela, Ramchandra going to make friendship with monkeys, going to cross this ocean to reach Rishyasringa Parvat. From there, Hanumanji Maharaj wanted to take the information of Sita Devi, where Sita Devi is. All information you can get in Ramayana. But the main thing, vital thing is that Ramchandra wanted to kill Ravan, wanted to give the responsibility to Vibhishan. Vibhishan was given responsibility of Lanka. So there was a big fighting, Ram. At the last day of Durga Puja, the Dasami day actually, Ramchandra wanted to cross this ocean by the help of Hanuman and other monkeys. They are writing Ram Nam on stone. Ram. They are writing the name of Ram in each stone block. They are going to throw in ocean and the stone floating. This way they are making a nice bridge from Rameswaram up to Lanka. After that, Ramchandra and all the troops of, monkeys, they all reach there. They had a big fighting with Ravan, and Hanumanji Maharaj was caught by Ravan. Hanumanji was caught by Ravan purposely. Hanumanji Maharaj thought, I like to see who is Ravan. But how I can see? So, Hanumanji Maharaj playing this way. So everybody, those were the messengers of Ravan. They are going to catch Hanumanji Maharaj, who is so powerful, nobody can catch him, but purposely. And now going in front of Ravan, and Ravanji Maharaj sitting in throne, very high gallery stone, a throne, and Ravanji Maharaj asking, "Hey, what is your identity? What is your identity?" Hanumanji Maharaj first thinking, Ravan is full of false ego, so I can teach him something. So when Ravan not allowing any seat, chair, anything to give honor to this devotee of Ram, then Hanumanji Maharaj himself going to make one big asana, more higher than Ravan asana, by the help of tail. His tail increasing tail. Hanuman increasing tail. Tail increasing. And coil. Then after that, Hanuman going to jump and sit over Ravan. Ramchandra laughing. Actually, Ravan laughing and say, "Hey, who are you? What is your identity?" Ultimately, Hanumanji Maharaj is Ganinang Barisham is thinking, "What identity I can speak?" He is foolish number one, fools of false ego. So in that case, Sita Devi coming in fine form and speaking in his ear, that why not you identify yourself as the servant of Ram? Hanumanji was saying, "Well, I can identify, but I know he cannot accept this, you know." Okay, done. Hanumanji Maharaj going to identify himself in front of Ravan. "Hey, who are you?" Hanumanji Maharaj speaking, "I am the servant of Ram." Hanumanji Maharaj speaking this way with full proud. And Lankapati, Lankadhis Ravan, laughing, "Ho, ho, ho, I think you are the king of some country. You are servant of Ram, huh? Your sword. You are the servant of Ram. Oh my God, I thought you are the king of some country." Hanumanji Maharaj speaking, "Yes, I am the servant of Ram, Paratpar Akhileshwar. You are the servant of Mayadevi. Don't laugh. You are the servant of Mayadevi. I am the servant of Paratpar Akhileshwar, Swayam Parabrahma Paratpar Akhileshwar, Sri Ram. So what's wrong in it?" Then Ravan giving order, "Hey, set fire in his tail. Vibhishan speaking, "King, it is not the duty, one messenger coming on behalf of some king, it is not the duty in political science that you cannot give punishment to anybody who is coming in the form of messenger." "Well, stop it. I don't like to hear your advice. Hey, set fire in the tail of Ram. Hey, the tail of Hanuman." Hanumanji Maharaj laughing. Now actually, I can start Leela. What? They are going to give cotton and cloth, old cotton and cloth in his tail. And after that, giving kerosene and ghee and set fire in the tail. Then Hanumanji Maharaj was thrown out of that palace, and Hanumanji Maharaj flying from one place to another place, and one place to another place, very, very chanchal, jumping here and there, and whole Lanka was set ablaze. Whole Lanka, fire everywhere. Ravan could not expect. Ravan thought that I am setting fire, Hanuman can die. But Hanuman not dying. He is that they are going to do some Ram Seva. All where whole Lanka burning, fire. Ravan said, "How it is possible?" "Well, Maharaj, you throw out this monkey, and monkey jumping here and there, and fire was there in his tail, and he is setting fire." "Oh my God! Golden Lanka was just burnt up into ash, turned into ash." After that, someday, somebody asking, Sugriva of somebody, I forget, "You kill whole Lanka?" Somebody asking to Hanumanji Maharaj, "Hanuman, You are Vaishnav. You are the servant of Ram. Parat. How is possible for you to kill all Lanka Vasi? Those are dwellers of Lanka. They all die because of you. You die. You kill them. Hanumanji Maharaj said, no, I never killed them. You killed them, but you set fire? That's why they are dying? No, I never killed them. You not, but all Lankavasi dying because of you. But I have done the seva of Ram. I have not done this kind of mistake. This actually, I have done Ram seva. I have done some Ram seva. I have done the seva of Ramchandra. I am not going to kill anybody. Maybe they are going to die. But I am not responsible. I am only doing Ram seva. I am not responsible. All Dandakarana, when Ramchandra was there in Dandakarana with Sita Devi, Dandakarana Vasi, they all Rishi Manis, they are very impressed. They are very really impressed to see the figure of Ramchandra. They wanted to get Ramchandra as their husband, all Muni Rishis. Ramchandra could realize their heart. Those Rishi Munis, they wanted to speak something, but they cannot speak because they feel shy. They feel shy to see the beautiful figure of Ramchandra, Durvadara Syam, Ghana Syam. Durvadara Syam. They wanted to get the relationship, very nice relationship with Ramchandra. They want to get Ramchandra as their husband, but they cannot speak clearly. Ramchandra could realize the heart of those Dandakarana Vasi, Munirishis, and Ramchandra going to promise them, no, now I have some ethical character, I have some responsibility, idealism. I cannot break. When I can come in the form of Brajendanandan, when I can come as the son of Nanda Maharaj, I can fulfill all your desire. But not now. I have some ekpatnidor. I have only one wife. Not two wives. Not two wife ethical character. No, not possible. This life you cannot get. But next life, when I can come in the form of Brajendanandan, then I can fulfill all your heart. Those, Muni Rishis, they are waiting for a long time to take the scope to get the association of Nandanandan Krishna, because in Ramlila, there is idealism, ethical character, everything, strict regulation there. So, they couldn't fulfill their heart. And even when Sita Devi was sent to exile, after the main exile was over, 14 years. Again, Sita Devi was sent, I already told. Sita Devi was sent to exile in the ashram of Vishwamitra Muni there. And in that case, Ramchandra Maharaj going to follow all strict rules and regulation. He is going to donate all different lands and properties to Brahmin Vaishnav. This way, Ramchandra going to show us the ethical character. Without the help of Ramchandra, we cannot understand those, because everybody cannot understand Krishna. It is not possible for everybody. It is not possible for everybody to understand the Leela of Krishna. Not possible. It is not possible. So Ram Leela, we cannot ignore Ram Leela. We love Ram Leela. We can get some teachings from Ram Leela. And because Ramchandra, when Sita Devi was sent to exile, while Ramchandra going to do Jagya, it is there in Shastra, in Ramayana. That whenever one king like to do Jagya, need wife to stay with him. But wife gone to forest. That's why Ramchandra every time used to make the deities of Sita Devi. Every time, whenever, in 60,000 years, so many Jagya was done by Ramchandra, each and every Jagya, Sita Devi, one deity of Sita Devi, golden deity of Sita Devi, Ramchandra used to make every time, to install the deity by Brahman Vaishnav, used to keep Sita Devi left side of Ramchandra and used to do Jagya. That is the system. But all, all, you know, countless golden Sita, they also took form in Krishna Leela as a gopi. One type of gopi is not there. Dandakaranavasi, they are also gopi. All Mlecha Pulind, all, you know, Pulindo, those who are low caste, they are also taking the form of gopi in Krishna Leela. These were all different kind of very beautiful, charming Leela going on. So without Ram Leela, we cannot understand. Without Ram Leela, everybody cannot understand Krishna Leela. So it is very good. It is very good because Ramchandra is Marjada Purushottama. Marjada Purushottama. Ramchandra going to protect the etiquette, the dignity. Ramchandra each and every time going to protect and show the dignity of behavior, dignity of Guru Vaishnava, dignity of, you know, all, you know, subject, those who are praja, those who are staying in countries, dignity of Brahman Vaishnava, always every time. So humbleness, so tenderness, we cannot expect in other of the, never. We can never expect this kind of humbleness anywhere. So Ramchandra, when Vishwamitra, actually long ago, I am not maintaining any serial discussion. Sometime I am being up and down. Long ago, when Ram Lakshan growing up, that time, actually Vishwamitra Muni wanted to take the help of Ram Lakshan. He wanted to beg Ram Lakshan from Dasharatha Raja. But Dasharatha Raja was, you know, he was not ready to give, because Ram is hurt. So I cannot give, but finally he was bound to give Ram and Lakshan. So in the way of forest, is, you know, Vishwamitra Muni giving order to Ramchandra and Lakshan to kill Taraka Rakshasi. Taraka Rakshasi was killed. They finally, finally reaching Janakpuri. They are traveling different place. Vishwamitra Muni and two disciples mean Ramchandra and Lakshmanji, they think themselves as disciple of Gurudev, that they are going to reach Janakpuri. Janakpuri is the palace of Janak Maharaj, who is the father of Sita Devi. Janak Maharaj going to arrange one yajna in which Sita can accept fancifully. Sita can accept one husband fancifully, arbitrarily, you know, fancifully. So they are going to arrange one yajna. They are actually Ram and Lakshan staying with Vishwamitra Muni in a garden, very nice garden in Mithila. One day, Vishwamitra Muni asking, Ram, I heard your father, Dasaraji Maharaj, already coming here in Janakpuri. You like to meet your father? Actually, to see the submission, how much submission is there? Vishwamitra Muni asking to Ramchandra, I heard your father, Dasaraji Maharaj, already reached, you know, Janakpuri to meet with Janak Maharaj. You like to meet him? Ramchandra speaking with shrugging head, bent head, thinking, Gurudev, as you like, you can do. I have no personal desire. As you like, you can do. So, very humble, even not looking at Gurudev, with humbleness, with shrugging head, bent out head, very politely paying dandavat to Gurudev and speaking, Gurudev, as you like, I have no separate desire. Then Vishwamitra Muni, hearing that yajna, they know everything, that Sita is the eternal wife of Ramchandra, I mean Shakti, Ram Shakti, Sita. So arrange yajna, and they are with Vishwamitra Muni, they are also going to win the yajna, Yogya Jai Karajana. There is some bet. There is one bet, but nobody could Harodhenu Bhango, nobody could break that bow and arrow. Finally, Ramchandra was there, like very light, you know, wooden piece, take up and break the, you know, break the bow and arrow. Then everybody shouting, Ho Ram, Ho Ram, actually, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Then finally, Sita Devi, she wanted to give garland on the head of Ramchandra, but Ramchandra is very long, very tall figure. Sita Devi cannot reach up to that point. How to, with garland, Sita Devi waiting in front of Ramchandra, and Ramchandra not going to, you know, to come down. Ramchandra is tall figure. Sita Devi cannot reach up to that part to give the garland on the shoulder of, you know. Then Lakshmanji Maharaj is very clever. Lakshmanji Maharaj going to touch the lotus feet of Ram. Whenever Lakshmanji Maharaj going to touch the lotus feet of Ram, it was a usual procedure. Ramchandra become bent down and catch and kiss him and embrace him. Oh, my brother! In the meantime, Sita Devi getting the chance to give the garland on the head of Ramchandra Maharaj. Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram. 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 Sri Ram Chandra Ki Palu Bhaju Mana. Harana bhava bhaya darunam Sri Ram Chandra ki palu bhajumana Harana bhava bhaya darunam Nava kanja lochana kanja mukhakara Kanja pada kanja arunam Kandar payaganita yamita chavinava Nila nirada sundaram patapita manu tarita ruchi suchi Naumi janaka sutavaram Bhajudina bandhu dinesho dhanava Daita bangsa nikandanam Raghunanda ananda kanda kaushala Chandra dasaratha nandanam Sira mukuta kundala tilaka charu Udaru anga vibhushanam Ajanu bhujasara chapadharasam Gramajita karadushanam Iti badati tulasi dasa sankara Sesa munimanaranjanam Mama hidaya kanjani Nivasu kuru kamadi khaladala bhanjanam Mama hidaya kanja nivasu kuru kamadi khaladala bhanjanam Sri Ram Chandra ki palu bhajumana Harana bhava bhaya darunam Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Jai Ram Bancha kalpadarvasya kipasindu bhavacha Patitanang pavana bhavishna bhyo namo